take an offering at the intermission. Jim has called the pediatric wards of St. Francis and Swedish American Memorial. Got the names of children who will be in the pediatric ward for Christmas. And he will take the money from the offering tonight to buy gifts for them. So we can have a part of that. We are very pleased to have Jim giving this concert. And you want to start with a prayer, right? Let us pray. We give thanks for this wonderful occasion in the season of the year, for the snow of winter and the beauty of the decorations and the pageant, for the deep truth of the coming of Christ among us. May your blessing be upon us and on Jim as we celebrate together in the name of Christ.
Thank you. here with us, so we appreciate you making it out, and we hope you enjoy it.
Let's take that rolling forest and sing a chorus.
needs no introduction around here, Mitch Olson, playing keyboards. And playing guitar from Northern Illinois University, Mark Morazzi. Everybody, I should hope, recognize the songs Let It Snow, Let It Snow, Let It Snow, which it certainly is doing, and Sleigh Ride. On now, called Sweet Little Jesus Boy.
See.
Harris artist. Most recently, Natalie Pohl. The song is called Grown Up Christmas List.
Christmas Day.
how the weather is. But if any of all the kids, if they can come forward, I'd like to have them help me sing the next song. The last song before we take a brief interview. We're going to do a different kind of a Christmas song. It tells the Christmas story from Joseph's point of view. Appropriately, it's called Joseph's Song. How could it be? Thank you. celebration here, and we'll play some Christmas music for you while we take a quick break. We'll be back in a few minutes.
May your blessing be alone on these gifts, O Lord, and may your blessing be with all the children for whom these gifts are given, in the name of Christ. Amen.
Stop like Eskimos. times many ways. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to
Thank you.
next song we're going to do, we always like to throw a challenge in for ourselves, so we're going to do a song that, because of copyright laws, doesn't get published very often. So we're going to fake it.
Watching the snow as the candle Shine.
said earlier, we're going to have an audience participation. I'd like to ask everybody to help us sing a couple Christmas carols. We'll see if, does anybody have a favorite carol they'd like to hear?
Request.
Request. Which one? Hark the Herald Angels Sing. So everybody sing with us.
Stump the organ.
Thank you.
Well, before we end tonight, there's a few people I need to thank. First of all, Mitch spent many hours here rehearsing music and helping me set up the program. So he deserves a big round of applause. Mark Moraski again. Mark, just stand up and be powerful. My wife Anita, my brother John, and my friend Stephanie for taking the collection tonight. I owe a huge thanks to my secretary from work, Barb Sutherland. She did a lot of the calling for me to the hospitals and put a lot of that into me. I owe a big thanks to Christ United Methodist Church for allowing me the opportunity to perform here. Not just tonight, but throughout the year. It gives me an opportunity to do what I like doing. And thanks to all of you for coming out tonight, braving the frozen tundra outside to be here. We're going to end. I'm going to sing the first verse of this carol, and I'd like everybody to sing the second verse with us. I did forget another important thank you. Kevin Polisek, who's up in the upstairs loft there, videotaping for us. We have several people who wanted to attend the concert tonight, but were unable to for different reasons, so this tape will be distributed to them also. And again, thanks to all of you for coming by.
too many on, you're better off having too few, I think.
Yeah, I think they went to the same school you went to. If you have 12, you want to get to 11, you go to 10, something like that.
Yeah, you take two off.
Yeah. You know what's scary about this is I observed the two of you, that Phil is beginning to understand what you're saying. This is unbelievable.
That's a good point.
Well, they start from the 17. Tommy Vardell is on the field. Testaverde with the time and throws deep over the head of Andre Rison. That's the first time that his look for Rison was covered by Williams.
But right there, Vinny really played it kind of safe, and it was a good thing because Andre Rison is well covered. You're going to see Willie Williams. He has deep safety help, so he does a good job of staying to Andre's outside. Now look at that. If Vinny made a good throw right here, Willie Williams been right in position to make the interception.
Did you see Willie Williams that was just, if you just watch his head, he was watching Rison the whole way because he knew he had deep coverage, and he just followed Rison. Where you're going, I'm going. I'm your shadow.
Second down and 10 of the 17. Just over 4 minutes to go. First half. Out across the 20, stopped by Bill Johnson. In the conversation we had yesterday with Pepper Johnson, he was talking about Rison. He said, you know, during preseason, I thought Andre would be a big plus, but when the games began, it seemed that all had changed with the $17 million contract, Andre's production so low. He said, guys actually became annoyed and jealous. And it's quite evident.
Well, that a couple reasons. First, when you start losing, you look for reasons why. They go, well, he's making all the money. He should be making more plays and helping us win football games.
Third down and 7. A jump pass completed to Byron. And he has a first down across the 30-yard line. Jason Gilden on the stop. It's a 12-yard advantage.
Yeah, this is not the primary target, as we'll see. Testaverde going back, and he's just looking to go right now. He sees Biner, sees the linebackers pull off, and when they do that, he just dumps the ball to Biner, who is wide open.
Yeah, he jumped because he saw that pass covering defensive lineman Winston Buckner right there ready to hit him.
Timeout has been taken by the Steelers with 2:41 left in the half.
Honda presents Great Drive.
This is incredible.
In the 1991 playoffs, the Broncos were trapped on their own two with just minutes to play. Trailing by 1 point, they faced a do-or-die drive. Stay tuned.
Cheers. Introducing the new Civic from Honda. More room. More refined. More luxury. The new Civic from Honda.
Preferring to do rather than die, comeback king John Elway directed his team on yet another memorable drive, converting two critical fourth down plays to set the Broncos up for a game-winning field goal.
Do whatever it takes to get to Subway for an Ace Ventura meal deal featuring a hot and delicious 6-inch Subway melt sub. You'll get an Ace Ventura collector's cup and valuable coupons, but only while supplies last.
Subway, what a sandwich.
True perfectionists never cut corners. However, they will, on occasion, have to sand them. Introducing the VersaPak Cordless Detail Sander from Black & Decker. It's how things get done.
Remember the last time the Chiefs and Raiders met? Chiefs Raiders 2, next Sunday on the NFL on NBC.
Well, the people have turned out here in Cleveland. There was a question as to how many no-shows. Well, there's somebody with a bone to pick, I would have to say.
Wow.
That hurts. Contention.
Yes.
Right,
the no-show count will be noteworthy, but this is a game that was sold out back in September. First down of the 33, you saw movement and a flag. Testaverde off the double pump, intended for Rison.
Kevin Green was offside. He moved, and the defensive lineman moved, and Green was gone, number 91. But now did the offensive lineman move?
Offsides. Defense number 91. 5-yard penalty. Repeat the down. First down.
You know, I love it. One of the other players said, hey, they moved. And Kevin Green, the guy that was offside, knows. He knows that they didn't move.
Paul, I think those officials for many years, they never listen.
And the Steelers have had problems in the penalty department this season. They've averaged better than 8 per game. Bill Cowher was telling us last night he could understand the penalties before the snap. But after the snap, a different situation. So those are subjective. Bader makes the catch right at the marker. Myron Bell, the strong safety on the stop.
I think what he was saying, the ones before the snap, we have to stop those, the offsides, the encroachments, those type of penalties. The one after, he can handle those because the players are being aggressive, getting called for penalties that way.
That was the point I was attempting to make.
The most scary, I understood you.
Yes. And Bader had it, not able to hold on. It is ruled incomplete.
You know, the other thing about it is that we ask him, he says, you know, what can you do and what have you done? And Bill Cowher said, well, we addressed it.
Yes.
And I got that perfectly. I understood that. You know the scary thing when you said Phil is starting to understand things I say, Marv? You know that last week's game, which one was it?
Yeah.
This is our 3rd in 7 days. In Dallas. No, in Cincinnati. I said three something. He says, you know, 3 times I was going to say the same thing before you said it. And that's really scary.
Well, you know, they say the same thing about people who have been married for a long time.
Wrong. That's wrong.
Paul, that's kind of cute.
It is a second down and 10. And on the draw, Biner got the call. Greg Lloyd with the tackle. 2 minutes remaining in this first half. We'll be back in Cleveland in a moment.
Did you ever notice how many times a day you look at your watch? More women rely on a watch made by Citizen than any other timepiece. Because more women prefer a watch made by Citizen than any other timepiece on Earth. Citizen, how the world tells time.
Dean Witter believed in listening.
Listen, not only to what our clients say, but what they mean. Each client has a level of comfort. Endeavor to find it. We measure success one investor at a time.
Think in color. Your computer thinks in color. So how come everything you print comes out black and white?
Black and white.
The Epson Stylus color printers, starting at $349 for the kind of brilliant color that will let your ideas be heard. You've got to see it in Epson color.
Beautiful 45 degree night here in Cleveland as we close it on the end of this first half. And coming up at halftime, we'll be sending you to our New York studios. Greg Gumbel, Mike Ditka, and Joe Gibbs will get you caught up in all the action from this 13th week in the NFL that's coming up at halftime. Marv Albert, Phil Sims, Paul McGuire from Cleveland with the Steelers in command 17-3. It's a 3rd and 8 as we resume. Cleveland from their 46-yard line. Again, you can see the movement as the flags are tossed. The completion for the first time to Rison. Andre Rison, Parnell Lake on the star. Andre Rison is hearing it from the crowd. He had some critical statements to make about the fans earlier this weekend. A number of Browns players wanted to make it clear they were not aligned with Andre in terms of the opinions.
Well, another thing about Andre.
Defense number 91. Penalty is declined. Result of the play. First down.
That's the penalties that Bill Cowher's talking about when you see 2 times in a row now you get Green offside. or two out of three times. Here he comes. He's gone. He's off. He pulls his other teammate off. The thing about Rising, he's making about $300,000 a catch right now.
And a first down at the 43, minute 50 left in the half as Testaverde throws deep. Incomplete intended for Jackson, who is covered by Fuller. And Perry, what Rising said earlier this week, he lashed out at the fans for the booing last week here at home, saying that I'll be glad when we get to Baltimore. Baltimore's our home. And he did not like the fact that fans were booing the Browns last week.
Well, that will endear you to the fans. Talk about, I can't wait to get to Baltimore. And, you know, it's been a rough year so far for Andre Rison. He said if he came in and he wasn't catching the ball, he would be happy as long as they won. Well, he's not catching, they're losing. So he's voicing his frustration.
Second down. 10. And the catch is made in front of Carnell Lake. Kenny McConnell on the reception.
See, here's where I think, take a timeout. You're going to go into third down.
Yeah, they did.
Thank you.
Timeout.
It'll be a third and about three coming up.
You know, sometimes being known as the parts expert can be mighty big shoes to fill. Of course, this time of year, I got some mighty big stockings to fill, too.
Come fill your stockings at Napa's Holiday Gift Sale, where you'll find great items at low prices. Like this special edition Napa toy truck, just $18.99. A clip-on halogen work lamp for only $15.99. And an eye-catching Napa toolbox for a low $9.99. The Holiday Gift Sale at Napa.
Keep America running.
Well, Paul, you mentioned right at the start of the telecast, Bill Belichick saying we no longer have a home field advantage here at Cleveland Stadium.
No, they really don't. If you take a look at the touchdowns allowed in 94 in eight games, that's the full schedule here, seven. And with six games, they already have 12. They're just total lack of concentration, and you don't need the players to go attacking the fans. These fans are upset. They're upset with the front office, with the people moving this football team. And the players can't understand, well, why are you mad at us? We didn't have anything to do with it. Well, you're part of the package, and that's what the problem is. They're hurt, and I can understand where they're coming from.
Minute 34 remaining. In this first half, it's a third and four at the 37-yard line. Trout short of a first down. Kevin Green made the stop.
Can you believe that play?
Well, they were trying to catch the Steelers off guard, but the Steelers had everybody bunched up inside. Looked like it might be a blitz. Right there, when that happens, you've really got to get out of the play, check out it, go to something that has a chance of working.
Now you got to go for it on fourth down, and I guarantee you they're not running.
Fourth and three. Jackson left, Rising right. Testaverde. Caught by Rising for the first down. Willie Williams on the stop, and again Andre's hearing it from this crowd as a timeout is taken by the Browns. Steelers have used all their timeouts.
Excellent job right there of Vinny just picking up the first down on the outside to Andre Rising.
Reminder, next week right here on NBC, it's an AFC West matchup with enormous playoff implications. The KC Chiefs travel to Oakland, taking on their arch rivals, the Raiders. First matchup this season. You'll recall James Hasty picking off that pass thrown by Jeff Hostetler in overtime. And that one at the game-winning score. The game also marking the return to Oakland of former Raiders player and coach Art Schell. That'll be next Sunday, the Chiefs and the Raiders.
Well, we'll be there. We're going to get there a little late. We have to go to Notre Dame first. We'll be there Saturday, and we're going to be there to watch this game. And it's a return of Phil Sims to Oakland. He's never been there, have you?
I've never been there. No.
That's right. It's a return. You've never been there.
You are going to Notre Dame for any specific reason?
No, just come on over there. No, we're going to a dinner. Are you kidding?
Giving out awards. Our first down at the 31-yard line. Testaverde able to find the wide-open Ernest Byner. Now the Browns have one timeout remaining.
Plenty of time. Now there's no reason to hurry. The 10-yard line, 40 seconds to go in a timeout. Just take your time.
And they move.
And Testaverde fires it. With his seventh touchdown reception of the season. He caught two last week against the Packers.
Good job of having composure by Michael Jackson and Vinny Testaverde, taking their time, catching the Steelers before they're ready to get set on defense and taking advantage of it.
Boy, you're right. They had plenty of time just to take your time, and that's exactly what Testaverde and the offense did, and they got a touchdown.
Randy Fuller slipped, fell down, and Michael Jackson able to make the catch. An 11-yard touchdown play. Puts it through. So with 31 seconds left in the half, the Steelers now lead the Browns 17-10.
Well, really, the play that led to the touchdown was Vinny Testaverde hanging into the pocket and dumping it over the middle. Here's Ernest Biner. He's just going to check out over here. And what happens is, it takes so long for the defensive line of the Steelers to get to him. Look at Testaverde looking around. Look at Ernest Biner in the middle. Nobody there. Good job by an experienced veteran quarterback of having patience and waiting.
Michael Jackson on the outside. The thing here is that Fuller falls down. Watch it. Here's Fuller goes down on the ground. The play might have been stopped. It would have been in position, but Michael Jackson sees it head to the end zone. But I like the fact that Testaverde is standing, and they really have not had a lot of pressure on Testaverde.
Look at Michael Jackson to the outside. Now watch Randy Fuller. For some reason, well, he just slips and stumbles right there, but there was no reason to be real aggressive because he could have just knocked him out of bounds in that situation.
And Vinny Testaverde with his 13th touchdown pass of the season. He's been picked off only five times, including the one here earlier today. So 13 plays, 83 yards, and 3 minutes and 33 seconds, and the Browns are back into it. Stover will kick it off. Ernie Mills is the deep man, but Stover puts it on the ground, and it's picked up by the tight end, Bruner. Bruner on the return, and we're down to 27 seconds left of the half.
Well, you just take a knee here because, first of all, the Pittsburgh Steelers, they have no timeouts. But the other thing is, we watch these guys. They do spectacular things. They're at the 40-yard line or 35-yard line. You may want to try and do something.
You know, I'm going back to the Cleveland's offensive series. I sat up here and watched the whole thing, and never did I have the feeling that they were driving towards a touchdown. It just seemed unorganized and nothing was happening, but the play to Ernest Blainer sparked them and maybe put them back into the game.
From the 34-yard line, the Pittsburgh Steelers just running out the clock. So that will do it for this first half, with the Steelers leading the Browns by the score of 17-10. The Browns able to get back into it with that late touchdown drive capped off by the pass from Testaverde to Jackson. Now to New York, and Greg Gumbel with the Domino's Pizza NFL on NBC Halftime Report.
This is the Domino's Pizza NFL on NBC Halftime Report, brought to you by Domino's Pizza. When it's gotta be great, and it's gotta be now, it's gotta be Domino's.
All right, Marv, thank you. Welcome, everyone, to our studios in New York. Greg Gumbel, Mike Ditka, Joe Gibbs, as we run down all the scores and highlights for you, beginning with the game that you are watching. The Steelers in control at halftime, but the late touchdown pass by Vinny Testaverde narrows the gap at 17-10 at the break. 3Com Park in San Francisco, the 49ers leading the Rams by a score of 21-7. Steve Young, 2 touchdown passes to the rookie, J.J. Stokes. In Houston, offensive shootout. The Oilers and the Broncos, it's 28-17. Houston in the lead. Chris Chandler has thrown 2 touchdown passes to the rookie Chris Sanders. In Arizona, the Cardinals trail the Atlanta Falcons 20-13. A couple of touchdown passes by Jeff George. Jesse Tuggle returned an interception 27 yards for a touchdown. In Seattle, the Seahawks, a scoring machine the last 3 weeks, 104 points. Shut out so far as they approach halftime. The Jets lead it 13-0. Earlier today at Rich Stadium in Buffalo, the Patriots rallied for a 35-25 win over the Buffalo Bills. The rookie running back Curtis Martin over 1,000 yards rushing today with 148 on the ground. Late in the second quarter, Bledsoe picked off by Cornelius Bennett. He goes 69 yards for the score, and the Bills led 19-10. But Bledsoe brought his team back in the fourth quarter. He hooked up with Ben Coates for the third time today. 15-yard touchdown, and the 2-point conversion made it 28-25 Patriots. The Bills trying to rally. Jim Kelly hit by Willie McGinnis, picked ripped out of the air by Chris Slade. He goes 27 yards for the touchdown. A terrific come-from-behind win for Bill Parcells and the Patriots, who improved to 5-7 on the year. The Bills fall to 8-4. The final is 35-25. Now, in Indianapolis, the Colts beat the Dolphins today, 36-28. Don Shula looking to his defensive coordinator, Tom Olivadotti. 7-0 Indy in the first. Dolphins have allowed 114 points their last three games. Jim Harbaugh, 3 touchdown passes today. This one, 34 yards to Aaron Bailey, 14-0 Indy. Marino broke Fran Tarkenton's all-time NFL record with the 343rd touchdown pass of his career. This 6-yarder to Keith Byers. The Dolphins trailed here 24-6. It was 24-14. Marino, who threw 4 TD passes today, but was also sacked 4 times. Tony Bennett nails him here for an Indianapolis safety. The Colts fall to 6-6. And take a look at this. If the playoffs began today, the Dolphins fall to 6-6, rather. If the playoffs began today, Kansas City, Oakland, Buffalo, Pittsburgh, Indianapolis, and Denver would be the playoff teams from the AFC. The teams on the bubble right now, Miami, Seattle, New England, and Cincinnati. And Joe, what does that tell you about the team that you said at the beginning of the year had the most talent in the AFC?
I certainly felt like they were one of the teams that had, you know, a chance to go all the way. I think in the first half of this game, a crucial game, you got to remember, they start off in the first half, it's like they're not out there. They do not protect Marino. He gets knocked around, and their defense doesn't show up, and they don't tackle anybody. Indy's playing good ball, but I think it was just a case of Miami making them look good today, and they didn't show up in the first half and got themselves in a hole.
Mike, every once in a while you hear Jimmy Johnson's name mentioned down in Miami for Don Shula's job. Is this likely to spark those rumors again?
There's no question it will. I mean, I don't know what's going to happen down there, but I mean, the thing I see, you know, you have a lot of play. You cannot let the inmates run the asylum. And that's what it looks like. These guys are arguing with each other, hollering at the coaches. Get rid of those guys or set them down. Get guys in there that have some discipline that want to play. That's what they have to do.
All right, so the final again, 36-28, the Colts win. In Green Bay, 3 more touchdown passes from Brett Favre. The Packers beat the Bucks 35-13. At the Meadowlands, a late field goal by Kevin Butler gives the Bears a 27-24 win over the Giants. In Washington, 2 Ricky Waters touchdowns. The Eagles beat the Redskins 14-7. And in Jacksonville, Jeff Blake, with 17 seconds to play in the game, a 5-yard touchdown pass to Carl Pickens. The Bengals beat the Jaguars 17-13. We'll send you back to Cleveland for the second half right after these messages and news headlines from your local station.
Monday night, they'll be coming for her daughter.
Oh, my God.
No! NBC presents an amazing motion picture experience.
I don't want to lose my daughter.
What's happening to
her? I think you know the answer.
Witness what happened to this family, and you may finally believe.
You can't just pretend like nothing happened.
Marquee Post.
I'm afraid it isn't over yet.
Prepare for the visitors of the night, NBC Monday.
Seed and herbicide system, the most powerful new idea in soybean production. Ultimate weather flexibility. Ultimate broadleaf control. No crop stress. All of which ultimately turns a soybean plant into a power plant. DuPont Synchrony STS. The bean machine.
It's here at last. Rex's grand opening celebration. Rex is celebrating the grand opening of 30 new stores. The better we buy, the bigger we grow, the bigger the savings for you on name brand audio, video, and appliances, and more. Like this 13-inch Zenith color TV, $129. Or this RCA VHS video cassette recorder, $149. And this JVC compact VHS-C ultralight camcorder with power zoom, $399. During Rex's grand opening celebration.
Thank you.
playing at home was their ace in the hole.
Well, it was, and I'd say right now they got themselves in a little bit of a mess here. They're now at 8-4, and they got to go to San Francisco next week. I think the one thing that New England's found out, Bill Parcells, when they rush the football, 148 yards a day from Curtis Martin, when they rush the football to go with Bledsoe, they can win ball games. But I think Buffalo had a lot to lose here, and they did in the fourth quarter.
And now they've got to go to San Francisco next week.
Correct.
All right. The Buffalo Bills lose their three-game winning streak. The Patriots improve to 5-7. The Bills fall to 8-4. In the RCA Dome in Indianapolis, the Colts over the Miami Dolphins today, 36-28. The Dolphins are 6-6. The Colts are 7-5. Good day for Jim Harbaugh, 180 yards and three touchdown passes. Another record-setting day for Dan Marino. He eclipses another Fran Tarkenton record, this one for career touchdown passes. He's up to 346 on the year. And what does that do to the AFC East? Take a look at the standings. Buffalo at 8-4. Indianapolis now pulls to within a game at 7-5. Miami at 6-6. New England 5-7. And the Jets in action out on the West Coast. They are 2-9 and out of the picture. At Green Bay, another outstanding day for Brett Favre. 35-13, the Packers beat the Tampa Bay Bucks. All Favre did was throw three more touchdown passes. Mikey has an NFL best 28 on the season. Three today, three last week, five the week before.
You know, and the amazing thing, too, you know, he lost one of the great receivers in the league when he lost Sterling Sharp, and they put other people in. He's spreading the ball around. But I tell you one thing about this guy. I know the guy. I met him a few times. He's a very tough-minded person. I say Mike Holmgren has done a great job with him in developing his confidence so that he looks where he's going to throw the ball. He knows what he's doing. He's not trying to make all the great plays that he used to make and turning the ball over. That's what's made him a better quarterback.
But he was 16 of 24 today, 267 yards and three touchdowns. Green Bay has now won three straight. They are 8-4 on the year. The Bucks are even at 6-6. At the Meadowlands, the Chicago Bears by a field goal over the New York Giants. Kevin Butler's field goal in the final minute of play gives the Bears the win by three. At RFK Stadium in Washington, the Philadelphia Eagles by a touchdown over the Redskins. The Eagles are 8-4 on the year. Ricky Waters has scored six touchdowns now in the last three games. He scored both TDs for Philadelphia today. The Eagles beat the Redskins 14-7. In Jacksonville, some last second heroics from the Bengals. The Bengals beat the Jaguars 17-13. Jeff Blake to Carl Pickens with 17 seconds to play from 5 yards out was the game winner. The Bengals beating the Jaguars to improve to 5-7, while Jacksonville is 3-9. And our NFL on NBC halftime activities continue.
We're back in Cleveland. Pittsburgh up by 7 over the Browns. Obviously, Brown fans are all shook up. After all, we are close to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame here in Cleveland. We'll be sending you to New York after a word from the NFL and your local station.
Tonight, at a special time, the biggest movie ever made.
Welcome to Jurassic Park.
The return of Jurassic Park, tonight at 8:30, 7:30 Central on NBC.
NBC Tuesday, it's an all-new Wings and an all-new News Radio. Then, the event everyone will be talking about. Maris is divorcing Niles. At least he's taking it well. Now, Frasier's got a new roommate.
I'm thinking of joining a gym, but I don't know whether aerobics or weight training is the quickest route to buff. Any thoughts?
A full hour of Frasier, NBC Tuesday.
Shop Farm and Fleet for incredible values during our holiday savings sale. A Waterloo 14-drawer tool cart, only $575. Waterloo 11-drawer tool chests are also on sale. Farm and Fleet has hemp plastic miter box kits, only $6.99. Hemp compound miter boxes, $39.99. Thorson tools are a great gift idea. Combination toolbox kits, only $49.99. Thorson socket sets are also on sale.
Find value. Farm and Fleet.
The Olympic Games return to America on NBC.
Hi, I'm Steve Largent, checking out a little personal history at the Pro Football Hall of Fame. I can't believe it's been 5 years since I last played a game in the National Football League. But now I can get right back into the action, thanks to an exciting and unique attraction called the 100-Yard Universe. Your official sideline pass admits you to the locker room theater, where where six channels of digital surround sound put you in the middle of pregame preparation. You'll never get closer to an NFL pep talk. Then some advanced technology puts a new spin on things, literally. This theater actually rotates, allowing the fans to follow the players on game day from the locker room to the field for the spectacular stadium show. It's a CinemaScope extravaganza, supported by an 80-piece orchestra that brings the action so close, you can almost touch it.
Watch out!
So take a trip to the Pro Football Hall of Fame in Canton, Ohio. You'll see NFL action like you've never seen it before in the 100-yard universe.
This message furnished by the National Football League.